Hey folks, it's Sunday time for Song of the Day, and I'm going to dispense with most of the intro here. This song is by Harry Chapin. It is called A Better Place to Be. He wrote it way back in the early 70s. He said he wrote it after he spent a week one afternoon in Waterton, New York. It's about a man who is going through some real challenges and some real downtimes, and a waitress, a wonderful, beautiful waitress who is trying to help him through that. And it's just really touching. It's one of my favorite Harry Chapin songs ever. So with that, I'm going to play A Better Place to Be. Was an early morning barroom, the place just opened up. Little man, he came in so fast, and he started at his cup. And the broad served the whiskey was a big old friendly girl, who tried to fight her empty nights by smiling at the world. And she said, "Hey, Bubba, it's been a while since you've been around. Where the hell have you been hiding, and why you look so down?" But the little man just sat there like he'd never heard a sound. Well, the waitress, she gave off with the coughing, acting not the least put off. She spoke once again. She said, "I don't want to bother you, consider it understood. I know I'm not no beauty queen, but I sure can listen good." Well, the little man took his drink in his hand and he raised it to his lips. He took a couple of sips and then he told the waitress the story. Watch the time go by. A week ago at the diner, I stopped to get a bite. Well, this here lovely lady, she sat two seats from my right. And Lord, 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 she was all right. She was so damn beautiful, she could warm the winter's frost. I'm not much of a mover or a pick-em-up easy guy, but I decided to glide on over and give it one good try. And Lord, 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 she was worth the try. I was tongue-tied like a schoolboy as I stammered out some words. It did not seem to matter much, cause I don't think she heard. She just looked right on through me to a place back of my head and shamed me in silence as quietly she said, "If you want me to come with you, well, that's alright with me, cause I know I'm going nowhere. Going anywhere is a better place to be." Well, I drove her to my boarding house. I took her up into my room. And as I went to turn on the light to brighten up the gloom, she said, "Please leave the light on. I don't mind the dark." And as her clothes all tumbled around her, I could hear my heart. The moonlight shone upon her as she lay there in my bed. It was the kind of scene I only had imagined in my head. I just could not believe it or to think that she was real. And as I tried to tell her, she said, "Shh, I know just how you feel." you. If you want to come here with me, well, that's alright with me, 'cause I know I've been so lonely. Loving anyone is a better place to be. Well, the morning came so quickly as I held her in my arms. Well, she slept like a baby, snug and safe from harm. I did not want to share her or to steer to break the mood. So before she woke, I went out to buy us both some food. I came back with my paper bag to find that she was gone. She left a 6-word letter, said it's time that I move on. You know, the waitress took a bar rag, she wiped it across her eyes. As she spoke, her voice came out as something like a sigh. She said, I wish that I were beautiful, or that you were halfway blind. And I wish I weren't so goddamn fat, and I wish that you were mine. And I'd wish that you'd come with me when I leave for home, 'cause we both know all about loneliness and being all alone. But the little man looked at the empty glass in his hand, and he smiled a crooked grin. He said, I guess I'm out of gin. And I know we've both been so lonely, so if you want to come here with me, well, that's all right with me, 'cause I know I'm going nowhere, and anywhere is a better place to be.
All right, folks, a little Harry Chapin for you on a Sunday. Stay healthy, stay safe.